Hello children, we are discussing the chapter 12, that is friction of your book. We have discussed certain topics which we will revise first in this video. The first topic which we discussed in this chapter is what is friction. So in the introduction of friction, we had studied a ball rolling over a surface stops after some time. It is because of the friction between the surface of the ball and surface of the ground. The second one, the example which we had studied was during the bicycling. When you are pedaling a bicycle and it stops the pedaling, then bicycle automatically slows down and then stops. Next we discuss, what is the cause of this friction? What is the reason behind this friction when the two objects are in direct contact with each other? The cause of the friction is the microscopic irregularities or microscopic hills and valleys which is present in the every surface, whether that surface has a rough nature or a smooth surface. Every surface has certain microscopic irregularities or roughness in the form of hills and valleys. And when two objects are in direct contact with each other, then these irregularities interlock with each other. And due to that interlocking of the irregularities, an object possesses friction over the other. That is the cause of friction. That is, irregularities or roughness of the surfaces in contact is the main cause of friction. More the roughness means more friction, and less roughness means less friction. Next, the types of friction. There are in total three types of friction. The first one is static friction. The opposing force, the frictional force, which comes into play when one object is placed over the other and none of them is moving. So when two objects are in direct contact with each other, the frictional force between these two objects is known as static friction. The main thing, the main point which is to be focused in this definition, which is that the objects must be at rest. The position must be static. That means the object does not possess any kind of motion. Second is limiting friction. It is the maximum amount of static friction which acts between the two objects, which comes into play between the two objects, which are in the direct contact with each other, and one object is just on the verge of motion over the other. Ye bachcho, maximum amount of static friction hai kab jab ek object dusre object par pada hai aur bilkul just move hone hi wala hai. That friction is known as limiting friction. The third one is kinetic friction. Kinetic means the movement, the motion. The frictional force which comes into play when one object moves over the surface of another object. Let us consider two objects are in direct contact with each other and one is moving over the other, then the frictional force is known as kinetic friction. Kinetic friction is of two different kinds on the basis of type of motion. The first one is sliding friction. The frictional force, the opposing force which comes into play when one object slides over the surface of another is known as sliding friction. The second one is rolling friction, rolling kinetic friction. The frictional force or the opposing force that comes into play when one object rolls over the surface of other object, that is known as rolling friction. One thing that must be kept in mind is rolling friction is always less than sliding friction. For that particular reason, we also convert sliding friction into rolling friction in some of our cases. For example, the large stands like Elmira's and large TV stands the refrigerators are put over the stands which have rollers in it, small rollers, and those rollers will reduce the friction of those heavy surfaces and we can easily move them from one place to another. Next, factors affecting friction. There are in total two factors which affects the friction. The first one is nature of the surface of the objects which are in direct contact, and the second one is weight of the object. First, we'll discuss the first factor, that is nature of the surface in contact. More the roughness of a particular surface, that surface pose more friction. Jitni irregularities zyada hongi, jitna surface rough hoga, utna us surface ka friction zyada hoga. Aur jitna ek surface mein irregularities kam hongi, jitna ek surface zyada smooth hoga, utna friction kam hoga. Aur us surface par chalna utna hi mushkil ho jayega. It would be very difficult to walk on the surface which has very less friction. Example, the surface, the marble floor with the oil over it, the wet marble floor. These cases have the floor possessing less friction because of the smoothness is increased by the water or by oil. Next one, the weight of the object. More the weight of a particular object, it poses more friction over the other surface. Jitna bachcho ek surface ka ek object ka weight zyada hoga, utna wo object zyada friction pose karega. Aur jitna ek object ka weight kam hoga, utna uska friction kam hoga. So if you have a larger ball and if you have a smaller ball, which ball will pose more friction? The ball which has more mass, which has more weight over the surface, that will pose more friction from that particular surface, or you know, from the earth surface. Whereas the smaller ball which has less weight will pose less friction. So that is the two factors. These are the two factors on which friction depends. We'll discuss the fluid friction. What are fluids? Any substance, any state of matter which can flow easily is known as fluid. Out of three states of matter, solid, liquid and gas, liquid and gases are considered as fluids. So whensoever an object floats in or over the air or water, those liquids or gases will exert a friction over the substance, over that particular object, and that friction which is exerted by the liquids or gases on the object which is floating in it is known as fluid friction. When we are swimming, then water exerts a force over or opposite to our motion. Water tends to oppose our motion. That opposing force by that water is known as fluid friction. That frictional force which a fluid exert is known as drag. So the frictional force of or exerted by fluids has given a special name, and that special name is drag. So if someone asks you what is drag, the frictional force exerted by the fluids is known as drag. Next, we'll check friction due to water as well as air. So whensoever an object flows or you know remains suspended or moves in air or a liquid, then they exert some opposing force to its motion, and that opposing force is known as frictional force. To overcome that force, to reduce that frictional force and makes the motion easier, the body shape of certain objects and living organisms are made streamlined. A very important shape and a question to be discussed regarding this chapter. What is a streamlined shape? The shape of an object having tapering ends and thicker from the middle. So these are the ends, these are the tapered ends, and the thickness is towards the middle. Generally the shape fishes and the boat bases are of this kind of shape. So this is somewhat tapering ends and it is thicker from the middle. So this is the streamlined shape. Streamlined shape helps in reduction of the frictional force which is exerted by the liquid over the fishes, which is exerted by the air over the birds, which is exerted by the air over the aeroplanes, which is exerted by the water over the boats, over the ships. So to reduce that frictional force, the shape is to be maintained as a streamlined shape. So what is the advantage? This shape offers minimum friction to the objects floating in the fluids. And to reduce that friction, the living organisms like birds and fishes are of streamlined shape, and the objects, the non-living objects like ships, motorboats and aeroplanes are also to be made in the form of streamlined body shape. Next topic is, friction is a necessary evil. Friction causes certain damages to machines, to certain objects due to the roughness of surfaces, but still, in some cases, friction is necessary. Without friction, we can't do many useful things. So first of all, before studying the disadvantages of friction, we'll discuss what are the advantages of friction. Why we call it a necessary evil? It is necessary for us, but still it causes certain evil things, certain damages. So first is, bache, due to friction only, we can be able to walk easily on the ground. If there is no friction between the ground and our feet, then our feet will not be able to move. We used to, skid over that surface. That is the particular reason, bache, why we cannot be able to move on a wet marble floor or an oily surface. Because that surface has very, low friction, extremely low friction. So that is why it is not easy for walk. It is easy to walk for us on the oily surface, or you can say on the wet marble floor. Second thing is, bache, the movement of vehicles. Just like our movement, the vehicles are moved on the ground because of the friction between the tires of the vehicles and the ground. More the grooves over the tires means less skidding. You must have observed the tires, bache. Tires mein kuch is tarah ke gadde se hote hain. There are certain grooves in them. Those grooves will bring the irregularities, and those irregularities brings the better grip for the tires of the vehicles with the ground. So, more friction between the tire and the surface, that means more grip of that particular vehicle is there. Next, spiked shoes for better grip. You must have seen various athletes wearing spiked shoes. Their shoes, has certain spikes. Why athletes wore the shoes which has spikes? Because spikes increases the friction. Due to that increased friction, the grip with the surface is increased. So for the better grip with the surface, athletes wore spiked shoes. As spiked shoes increases the amount of irregularities, and by increasing the irregularities, the grip of an athlete with the ground increases. Next one is writing work. As I write, many things on this board, as well as I am writing again the name of the chapter. This writing is also results due to the friction between the tip of this marker and the surface of this board. If you hold a chalk and you want to write with the help of chalk on a glass, it would be, happen. You can't be able to write with the chalk on the glass. Why is it so? Because the surface of the glass is very smooth. It poses very less friction, due to which we are unable to write on the glass by the help of a chalk. So that is the particular reason why the chalk, you know, are very useful only in the case of, you know, boards which has irregularities, like green board and the black boards you must have observed in your school or somewhere else watching. Because they have irregularities, and due to those irregularities, the friction between the chalk and the board increases, and due to which we can be easily write on a board with more irregularities as compared to a glass board. Next, application of brakes. Every vehicle which moves has certain brakes along with it, and those brakes meant to stop that moving vehicle. So what is the purpose of brakes, Vachi? Brakes increases the friction between the brake lining and the drum or the, you know, moving part of the vehicle. Due to that, the motion of the tire is opposed. Suppose motion of the tire is in this direction. This is clockwise direction. So friction will exert a force in the anti-clockwise direction. Agar force is direction mein hai, to brake is direction mein force exert karegi, aur isse dheere dheere wo vehicle pehle slow hoga and ultimately it stops. Next is lighting a matchstick. When we lighten a matchstick, then what we have to do? We have to rub the matchstick with the corner, with the edges of it. So this is the matchstick, bache. This is the surface which contained red phosphorus over it, and this is the light matchstick which is to be lighted. When we rub this matchstick over this surface, and you must have observed that this surface has more roughness. Due to that more roughness, bache, when I rub this, you know, stick, the stick which has explosive material over it, over that, due to that rubbing, friction is more, and due to that rubbing over that, you know, rough surface, the heat generated or the temperature of this surface rises. Due to that temperature, due to that more temperature, high temperature, it catches fire. So this is because of the frictional force between the matchstick and its rough surface. The matchstick lightens when we rub it over that rough surface. Next is screws and nails. The screws and nails are remain, you know, fixed in the wood, in the wall, like these nails, bache, over which this white board is placed, bache. These nails are fixed. That is also because of the friction between the, you know, the irregularities of the nail and the wall. Due to that irregularities, due to that friction, the screws and the nails will remain upholded in the wall or in the wooden cabinets. One more example is there, bache. That example is of the, you know, when a shooting star or a meteor catches fire. When a shooting star will came out of the outer space into our atmosphere, then our atmosphere, our air, will exert a friction over it. Due to that friction, when a meteor which is coming from the upper surface at very high speed, when atmosphere comes in contact, due to that friction force, large heat is generated. And due to that large heat, that meteor catches fire. And that is why it is referred as a shooting star. So whensoever those shooting star or meteors enters into the atmosphere, their speed is quite high. And when they strike with the air, due to that striking, a frictional force is generated. And due to that large frictional force over that meteor, a large amount of heat is generated. Heat will result in the formation of fire. So these are the certain advantages of necessity of friction. It helps us to walk. It helps the movement of vehicles. Spiked shoes of athletes increase the friction, which increase the grip. Writing work, either on the board or on the paper by the help of pen or a marker, is also done due to the friction. Application of brake or stopping of certain vehicle by the brakes is also the application of friction. Lightening a matchstick is also because of the frictional force between the rubbing surface and the stick. And the last one is screws and nails will remain upholded in the wooden or in the, you know, walls because of the friction between the screws and those particular objects. Now we will discuss the ways to increase the friction for our good. we can increase the friction between the two objects by two methods. The first one is by making the surfaces in contact more rough. As we know, more the roughness of a surface, the frictional force exerted by that surface is more, and vice versa. So if we increase the roughness of a particular surface, then frictional force between the surfaces will increase. For example, bache, the matchstick is made rough, as well as the head, the side of the matchbox over which that matchstick is to be rubbed, is deliberately made rough. Both of those surfaces are rough. Due to the roughness of both surfaces, more friction is there, and due to more friction, more heat is generated, and due to that more heat, the matchstick lighten up very quickly. The second method is by increasing the grooves, by making the grooves. But you must have noticed the tires of the automobiles, like motorcycle, cars, trucks, buses, those tires have certain grooves in it. If you watch, you've seen a large tire of a tractor, it has large grooves, you know, it has the grooves like this on the both sides of a tire. So these grooves increases the friction, and that increased friction provides the better grip for those heavy vehicles over the road surface, as well as those heavy vehicles will be stopped easily as they do not skid over the surface, and accidents may be prevented. Okay? That's why the brakes are there. You know, you must have heard of the ABS brake, anti-braking system, a very powerful braking system which provide more friction, bache, and the car stops at its own place. It do not skid at all to prevent any accident, bache. So grooves are provided in the tires of heavy vehicles or vehicles to increase friction, so that by that friction the tires will get a better grip on the road, which prevents skidding, slipping of the vehicle over that road.